Welcome to our channel. We specialize in updating the latest news on our favorite movie, The Young and the Restless. Please like, share and subscribe to receive notifications whenever a new video. Thank you and enjoy your video. The Young and the Restless, Y&R, spoilers for Tuesday, April 28th, bother that Katherine Chancellor, Jean Cooper, will by and by be at the focal point of some exemplary Y&R show. In this scene from July 2004, Katherine tosses a mediation slam and will not hear her out friends and family. She gives an impromptu speech rather and closes down everyone who attempts to talk some detect into her. Katherine wouldn't like to get calm, yet Brock Reynolds, Bokaser, feels like his mom's committing the regular old errors. He portrays his grievousness, and Jill Abbott, Jess Walton, gives Katherine an earful, as well. Arthur Hendricks, David Hedison, recollects how he began to look all starry-eyed at Katherine, yet he currently considers she's a control alcoholic. Lauren Fenmore, Tracy E. Bregman, speaks up to propose a Katherine they knew is gone, yet Katherine doesn't appear to be concerned. Katherine feels certain she'll outlast every one of them. After McKenzie, Mac, Browning, Ashley Basham, appears, she attempts to break through to her grandma. McIntosh takes steps to leave totally if Katherine won't stop this implosion. According to other Young and the Restless spoilers, Drusilla Winters, Victoria Rohl, makes an appearance in this fantastic flashback episode. Devon Hamilton, Britton James, gets a visit from Drusilla at the rec center, which leads to a face-off. Drusilla? S. worried about Devon leading Lily Winters, Crystal Callow, down the wrong path. They bicker about the money Devon stole and how Lily lied to the police, which Devon insists he didn't. He asks her to do. Devon rants about how Drew used to live on the streets and has no business judging him. Drusilla D-O-E-S-N? T want Devon around Lily and points out that she could call Devon? As social worker. When Lily comes to see Devon later, he pushes her away and suggests she should find another charity case. Lily? As visibly rattled, but a worker soon fills her in on Drew. S. recent visit. Over with John Abbott, Jerry Douglas. He contemplates a tough decision thanks to Victor Newman. S. Eric Breton, all fair. Jabo could use $75 million, but John D.O.E.S.N.? Do you know how to tell Jack Abbott, Peter Bergman, to go? Brett Carlton, Don Diamond, and Ashley Abbott, Arlene Davidson, know the money would do Jabo good right now, but this is extortion in John? S. opinion. Later, Jack? S. stunned to learn Victor? S. offer is even being considered. As a result, Jack ends up quitting on the spot. However, Jack and John come together a little later. John would rather have Jabo go broke than force Jack out, but Jack thinks Jabo needs the money. It? D.B. dumb to turn it down. John wanted Jack to carry on his legacy, so Jack insists that he will someday. He promises his dad he? I'll be back. Comment from the audience. I agree that these episodes are really great. Back in these days, the writers knew what great writing was and how to write a good soap storylines with lots of drama. I hope that the current writers are watching and paying really close attention to what good writing is. These old episodes are great. Hopefully the writers are watching them and learning what good writing is. I truly hate that Y&R is down. At the present for current shows, Bold and Beautiful as well. This really sucks to the 10th power. However, I will continue to nail it. Regarding the weekly quotes, I have a perfect record as you know. Wow. Original recipe Jack sounds just like me when I start ranting about the Newmans. Don? Don't worry, Jackie boy, some of us will never forget the many sins of Victor Newman, no matter how they try to paint him as some saintly patriarch these days. Not on my watch. Look at John Abbott at death's door. Think of all the dirty tricks Victor pulled on John. For shame. Now I am cranky about OLD storyline.